Well, hey there, guys. It's your favorite backyard geographer again. I was out in the garage going through my junk, and I thought of you. You know, dating back into the 1870s, many cigarette companies found a solution to supporting the flimsy packaging and really a better way to support the contents within by adding a piece of paper or cardstock to each pack. Although they were initially blank, an American businessman thought to print advertisements on them and to take advantage of the packaging to inform the world of everything from botany to movie stars on a silver screen. Join me today as I share something really different, unique, an original set of cigarette cards. So, between 1875 and the mid-1940s, cigarette companies would include these collectible cards in their packaging and became a prominent part of pop culture, often depicting, you know, the period's actresses, their costumes, sports, and even sometimes inappropriate humor. Most sets were between 25 and 50 different cards. A fun fact, the hobby of collecting cigarette cards is known as cardophily, and you have to remember that in the 1900s there were over 300 different cigarette manufacturers all producing these cards, to the point that it was very common to see children waiting outside the shops begging the consumers to give them their little cards that were in the packs. This type of advertisement would branch out into what is known as the miniature postcards of the 20th century. You have to again remember that in the early 1900s, people generally didn't have a camera. It was very expensive and clunky. So when visiting historical points of interest, you could purchase these tiny little cards to bring back to show your friends and family where you were. It was like a paper version of Instagram. To kind of give you an example of that, I've got a little stack here. These are just, again, very small handheld cards. This one here in particular is looking at north, right there at Grand Canyon. And so they're little small colorized little cards. So can you imagine going to a friend's house? Oh, I just got back from the Grand Canyon. How was it? Well, let me show you my photos. And this is, you know, how they would share it, which is very different from how we do it today. In the 1930s, the bigger tobacco companies had created special departments employing artists, researchers, and photographers for the sole purpose of preparing card issues on a regular basis. However, with the outbreak of the Second World War and the ensuing paper shortage, tobacco companies ceased producing these cards. Except for some brief periods in the 1950s, this practice was overall just disbanded. Some other companies that even got, you know, into this whole mix, which is kind of an interesting one, is Disney. The Disney company got involved in these cigarette cards, and there were, you know, several different sets that were available in Europe that you could collect. So this one, this set, framed set in particular, it says Film Stars of 1938. And so I'm going to pick this frame up here to share with you. And then on the back, actually I'll just kind of spin it around real quick. It's got a photocopy of all the cards. This is a complete series of cards, and it has a nice little history of the cigarette cards themselves. But as we can see here, when looking at this beautiful set, these are all Film Stars. This was the third series. This is all 25 cards that were available at that time. So some of these actors and actresses on this third series, you got Joan Crawford, Gary Cooper, Bette Davis, you got Errol Flynn, and again, you got a handful of other stars. If you're really into collecting things, there's also some really rare ones. One of the ones that I would love to get my hands on is a Walt Disney. Back in the 30s, Walt Disney made it onto a cigarette card in Europe. So I don't know, this is just something very different, unique. It's that piece of pop culture that was very different because it was only available to people who smoke cigarettes, but this was a huge collecting piece, kind of like baseball cards, right? For children, but obviously children weren't smoking and you shouldn't smoke either. But when it came to stuff like this, it was just really interesting on how it kind of brought the family together. So, you know, dad would go to the store, buy his pack of cigarettes, bring it home, unwrap it, and give, you know, their kids the little cards inside, and the kids would stack them up and try to collect the full and complete series. Other series that I've seen that are also as great as this, I mean, there's a beautiful botany. I've seen birds, I've seen mammals, I've seen so many different varieties. And so chances are you probably have seen a cigarette card at one point in your life and just thought, wow, that's a really small trading card. But now you know what it is. Maybe you have some cigarette cards at home. Be sure to let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll talk soon. Better way to support the contents by... Wait. Sorry, you're right. Now let's... Let me do this. We'll stop. Cut. Time out. I'm going to read it because I haven't looked at it. I was